Syrian state television is claiming more than 120 members of the government's security forces have been killed. It's the first time the channel has reported on any large-scale fighting during months of revolt.
In plain clothes and with his gun in plain sight, a Syrian security officer seems to target demonstrators. In another sequence posted to the internet, a policeman in riot gear brandishes a machete. It seems a stark contrast to protests that at least begin in peace. This is the northern town of Idlib, and not far from here, the government claims the most violent episode yet took place. State television news had only one astonishing story: the massacre of security personnel at the hands of gangs who'd taken over the town of Jisral Shagur, looted weapons and attacked a security post. The interior minister vowed to respond with force. But as the military moved in, the official account was contested. Opposition activists say the town has been the scene of a mutiny. Security forces who switch sides to join an uprising still, it seems, spreading.
If, and it's a big if, either version of events is close to the truth, it might mark a new and even more deadly phase to the rebellion, the transition perhaps from peaceful protest to armed insurrection.
John Ray, 10 News.